Welcome to another segment of The Word for Today. And the word for today is God cares. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 6 verse 30, "Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith?" Jesus was making the all-important point that many seem to forget, especially in the midst of troublesome times. That is, God cares. God's love led him to create a perfect world. But even more demonstrative of his love is his decision to give mankind free will. This gave mankind the power to choose opposite of God. Mankind was free to choose evil above good. Genesis 2 verse 17 tells us, "But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die." God is the giver of life. And what God was saying to mankind was, if you decide to choose a path other than me, it is a path that leads to death, because without me there is no life. Might I add that choice is more telling when the choices are diametrically opposed to each other? This choice led mankind into what is called a fallen world. That is, a world filled with things going wrong. Sickness, death, disaster. But even in the midst of man's clear choice, and even the consequences that followed, here again we see the love of God in living action. We see that God cares. God promised to send a savior in Genesis 3:15. God continued to communicate with man throughout the world. God continued to provide for man. He sends rain on the just and the unjust. John 3:16 and 17 captures it perfectly when it tells us, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." But why is he taking so long to rid the world of sin? The question is. Speaking about the coming of the Lord, Peter made an important point in 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9. He said, "The Lord is not slack concerning his promises, as some men count slackness, but is longsuffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance." The Greek word for longsuffering, it means to be patient in bearing the offenses and injuries of others, to be mild and slow in avenging, slow to anger, slow to punish. So Jesus, God needs patience in seeing us even in our suffering moments. He needs to exercise patience because he has to look at the long game. Your delay might just be another man's opportunity to accept the Lord. The love of God could become lost in the cloud of COVID-19 or the cloud of your personal sorrow and struggles. But regardless of the challenge, I declare with no doubt in my mind that God cares. Jeremiah 31 verse 3 tells us, "The Lord hath appeared of old unto me, saying, Yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love, and therefore with loving kindness have I drawn thee." God cares. He always has and he always will. An imperfect world does not overshadow the perfect love of God. The word for today is God cares.